Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I'm your host, Fahim Boshi, and I'm a vocal coach slash voice teacher. And today I'm going to be reacting and analyzing to Nirvana, Where Did You Go Last Night? So I know Nirvana, it's one of my favorite bands, but I have not checked out this performance, so this is going to be my initial reaction. So without any further ado, let's just go ahead and jump right into this video. Nice. I like the fact that he's barely opening his mouth and he has that kind of long, like that kind of thing going on, and that used to be very common in the 80s and the 90s, so really cool. Nice. This is live. I heard a little bit of pitch issue there, so this tells me that it's live. So very soft, soft chest voice singing. It's good. I like it. See that? A little bit of pitch issues there. So that tells me it's live and not pre-recorded or whatever. Really nice. I like it. I think it's gonna kill it later. I have a feeling. Nice. He's barely opening his mouth. He's like just being very conversational. Okay, so that part, like at the end, that was a full, more like a scream. So up until then, it was that sound where you kind of do like a nasal kind of distortion, but then you add more noise to the sound, so it becomes more like a scream kind of thing. Even though it had a pitch, you can hear those B flats, those B flat fours, those C sharp fours, and whatnot. Yeah, but it's basically a distortion, and you just distort the sound even more into a more scream kind of thing, but it's not a full scream, right? This is the type of sound that new metal bands like Linkin Park, Chester Bennington, he would use. He would use a very similar kind of sound. Like, it's not full like a distortion, it's more like a scream distortion. Does that make sense? Nice. Nice. Really good. And that's not straining, just so you know. Okay, it's a very healthy sound. The way he's doing it, it's quite healthy actually, because he knows how to do it the right way, you know? Extreme sounds are not bad if they're done correctly. Awesome stuff. Alright, so first let me go ahead and wrap this video up, and then I'll give you guys my analysis and some vocal thoughts. Alright, guys, so amazing, amazing job, amazing job. I mean, wow, this was a really good performance. This was live, this was unplugged, this was one take. I didn't hear any pre-recordings or whatever, you know what I mean? Really great vocals. I love the fact that he kept it very even and quiet up until the end, where he kind of get on, you know, full belt kind of distortion thing, and then he kind of like slayed those parts. And I didn't hear any strain or any pitch issues whatsoever, especially when he added that sort of, you know, distortion part, right? So that type of a sound, it's distortion, but then you, as I said earlier, that you kind of distort the tone even more, get into more like a fry scream or scream kind of a sound, right? In order to get that sound, you just have to experiment it. I mean, you need to have distortion for it first, and then you can slowly start experimenting with that sound. So during the beginning, at the middle part, it was kind of straining the spark, like it was very kind of speech-like quality. It had that country vibe to it, right? It had that country vibe to it, and the I wouldn't say full country. It's a little bit of country. I mean, this type of a trend, it used to be quite popular back in the 80s and the 90s, so he was kind of doing that. And I noticed that he didn't open, like, he barely opened his mouth, so that was kind of interesting, yeah. And he was being very speech like, he was just playing the guitar, playing those chords and whatnot, and just, you know, singing the song, which I personally like. So, it's very plain and simple, you know. And you know, as at the end, I mean, he just slayed the song with the high beltings and the distortion and scream kind of sounds. So, yeah, really good job, really good job. I really don't have anything else to add here. I mean, the vowels that he was using in the lower part, it was pretty much more or less like speech-like vowels, and then at the top, he kind of opened up a little bit since he was using a more powerful sound, a louder sound. So he was slightly opening up a little bit, but he wasn't like going super crazy with it or anything. So that was kind of nice. And yep, that's pretty much it. I really don't have anything else to add here, so I'll just wrap it up here. So there you go, guys. That's my reaction and my vocal analysis of Nirvana, Where Did You Sleep Last Night, unplugged. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something from this, because if you did, then please give this video a big old thumbs up and hit the notification bell and subscribe to my channel, and then hit the notification bell if you haven't already. Let me know in the comment section about your thoughts of this reaction video. And if you guys have any suggestions, then please, I encourage you to comment them below. And if you can, then please provide a link, because that would be really helpful for me. So I have a Facebook page and also an Instagram account where I try to share my videos of my own personal singing, as well as me, you know, helping other people out there with singing and whatnot. So I would really, really appreciate if you can go and check out my Facebook page and give it a like, and go and follow me on my Instagram page. I could really love the support, or I could really use the support. Last but not least, if you have any questions about your own singing, about vocal technique or artistry, or if you just want to go ahead and do a voice lesson with me, then you can directly go ahead and book a lesson with me at fiverr.com, which I will leave a link on the description. Or you can email me at fimushifreelance1@gmail.com. which I will leave it on the description as well, so you can contact me there. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.